We do encourage you to take initiative and to work towards building your DACOM and your performance objectives. And if you followed through our videos and looked at the resources, you should have enough key information to be able to build an effective DACOM. There's one more thing that we would encourage you to do, but again, this is up to you, and that is before you fill out this entire DACOM, before you fill out every single row, we encourage you to fill out your goals and maybe one or two rows just to make sure you're on the right track. Why is that important? Well, one of the biggest mistakes that people often make is that they had much too much information, and they either lose perspective of the fact that your goal is really a verb, an action on a particular subject. So this goal here, create a color wheel. So create is the verb, color wheel is the subject. That's a goal. And when you break down that create the color wheel, well, explaining the color theories is the sorry, explain theories of color perception would be the next logical step, or mixing secondary and tertiary colors would be part of it in creating the color wheel. The dye color samples, so making the samples would be part of it. So all these pieces, these objectives that are also subject and a verb, or a verb connected to a subject, go into this goal. The important part here is the verb alignment has to be accurate. And as you've seen in the literature, your verb in your goal has to be at the same level, equal to, or above all the other verbs in your objective. So create is a higher order verb, and explain, mix, dye, assemble all fit under that context. If you were to have identify a color wheel and then use explain or mix or assemble, well then that would be out of alignment because identification is a very, very low order task. So keep that in mind. These are key things that people often make a mistake on or overlook. So before you spend all your time building everything out, it's up to you, but you have the option to send in a quick snapshot of your goals and one or two lines of your objectives just to make sure you're on the right track. A few minutes of my time can save you perhaps many minutes or even hours of frustration of your time. So I'd encourage you, before you submit, take a look at this example, the color quilting making example. It's one of the examples on the Moodle site. If your DACOM doesn't look this simple, then you might need to revisit it. Also, one other thing that happens, quite often people forget, because they've added conditions and criteria to their DACOM, they forget to do the performance objectives. So when you simplify these things, you're knowing, well, explain the concept of shadows. Well, given what type of a condition you want your learner to explain the concept of shadows with respect to how highlights and can impact appearance. So that's a criteria, or you do it to a certain standard. Given in a classroom setting or in a demonstration, you would add a condition, a criteria to this D4 and turn that into a performance objective. You have to select 10 of these, and using the C3, the C4, the B2, or whatever, using the code to identify the performance objective on the next page below. You got two pages. You got a one-page DACOM. You got a one-page of performance objective. You add the condition and criteria to 10 of your objectives. You've got performance objectives. So before you submit, make sure your DACOM looks like this. Make sure you've got your performance objectives. If you want, do a line of goals, do all your goals, and do a line or two of your objectives. Submit that to me. I'll take a look at it. Make sure you're on the right track. If you want, if you've got a question about performance objectives, by all means, include one or two. I'll let you know if you're on the right track. A few minutes of, getting verification, a few minutes of feedback may save you many, many more minutes of frustration. So take advantage of the fact that we're here to help you to be successful, and I'm willing to take a look at the stuff before you go too far.